Good evening from Huddersfield. Now, we cannot expect the classical technical battle that we saw on Thursday night, because this game is a vital one, the toughest of all tasks, trying to get out of the second division, either Huddersfield Town or Coventry City. And there the gas works, the water cooling towers outside this crowded ground, a big crowd at Huddersfield, because the position is Huddersfield and Coventry are playing their last match of the season today. Both are 1 point ahead of Southampton, who've got three away games to play. So this match is a vital one. And Huddersfield Town are missing quickly their inside forward, a very fine player. We'll keep an eye on Nicholson, number four, a wonderful wing halfback they signed from Manchester United. And numbers eight and nine, Gilliver and Leighton, are their chief goal scorers. Huddersfield Town are in the strip, and nearest to us, all white, Coventry City. And it's good to see Glazier back in goal. He had a bad leg break. He's not been back more than a few weeks, but nice to see him there, and keep an eye on number 10 pointer. He's their main goal scorer, man they signed at Christmas from Bury, who's been worth every penny they paid for him. Those then are the two teams. Now, every game we've seen so far this season in Match of the Day has been important. But never before has a match had such a cruel penalty for the losers, because whoever loses today, Huddersfield or Coventry City, will be condemned to another season in the second division. So that then is the penalty facing the losers as we go into Match of the Day, Huddersfield versus Coventry City. Coventry City then to kick off. Coventry City playing all in white. The referee, Mr. Cowan of Oldham, just checking his watches. The rival supporters beginning their chants. Number nine, all white, gold, the centre forward for Coventry, start this vital promotion match. And all the Huddersfield fans will be hoping that their team will get back into their early season form, because they haven't been hitting it too well lately. They've only got 12 points in their last 13 games. That is hardly promotion for. This is Huddersfield now coming onto the attack. Leighton, their centre forward. Slow on that one. Should the promotion battle go to goal average, Huddersfield have the better chance. So far they have the best goal average. Worst goal average of the three promotion contenders, Coventry City. McHale for Huddersfield with a throw. This is Gilliver. Away goes. Brook, number four for Coventry. The ground got a soaking yesterday, but it seems very firm. Quite hard this afternoon. Throw to Coventry City. Rather corner to Coventry City. Corner being taken by Mitchin, the inside right. Okay. Kick has been given. Harris, brother of Chelsea's Ron Harris. Good as Gould. And a chance for Coventry. And there was a lot of hesitation in that Huddersfield defence. As Gould just limping a little with his left leg. That's got a painful little wrap. Burst through then. Mr. Cowan, referee from Holder, having a look at him. For follow then. The draw in this match, of course, is of little use to either Huddersfield Town or Coventry. The throw's got to be taken again. It was foul throw. Foul throw, so it's Huddersfield's throw now. Cairns, number two, to take the throw for Coventry to Farmer. And so far there's no score. Bingham bouncing in front of him. Had to take his chance. There he is, Gilliver. Inside right, quite often very centre forward. And somebody has thrown a bottle onto the pitch, which is rather a stupid thing to do. And it's in the Coventry goal mouth now being tossed into the back of the net. There it is, tossed into the back of the net by Ken. I don't think Glazier will like it being there. He could well fall on it. He's picking up now the bits of glass or... are they pennies? I think they must have been pennies. I don't blame Glazer. He's picked them all up and put them in his cap. ...20 minutes of this vital promotion game gone. No goals as yet. Coventry trying to progress down the middle, hoping that goal or pointer will be able to chase on to one. This is Machin back to Clements, the outside left. Sides making mistakes. They're over anxious in this match. And now it's number 10 pointer for Coventry. To centre forward Gould. Gould finding pointer. It will be a long-range shot from this fellow if he gets half the chance. But notice how McHale going back to cover and defence. This stint of challenging and harrying. McHale seeing a lot of the ball on the right. He's the wingman who loves to take on his fullback. This is Smith. Back to Nicholson. No score. And a foul. Nicholson charged from behind by Gould. There he is. Number 9, Coventry. We'll get a good view, I should think, of this free kick. And it's a wonderful save by Glazier from Lake. Now Nicholson. And another free kick to Huddersfield. Says it must be taken farther back. Coddington with the free kick for Huddersfield Town. Not such a good one this time. Rhys getting it up to goal for Coventry.
Play on, I think the referee has said.
Yes. England under 23 goalkeeper. And Coventry City. Penalised again, a foul on Littleson, who's now discarded shin pads. There you can see him. Well, he's a brave man to be playing in a match like this. The stockings rolled down, no shin pads. Time by Leighton on Curtis. Really, all these fouls are being caused. The players are over anxious. They're much too enthusiastic, if one can say that. Nothing really vicious in the game. McNabb for Huddersfield. Nicholson trying to lay it off for Leighton, who wasn't moving. Number 9, Leighton. Fine efforts. He's trying to claim it was a corner. The referee was near enough, and we were near enough to see that that was a goal kick. Coventry's throw. This is McNabb, the left back to Nicholson. And it's Coventry who move away now. Pointer. Goal chasing this one, and Coddington going across to take it. And is it a corner? Yes. Shot from Clements, turned round to a corner. Good move by Coventry. The corner is going to be taken by the inside right Meacham. Background behind Nicholson is number 4, the hero of Huddersfield of the month. Guarding near post, Atkins. And another corner to Coventry City. And again, it's Machen going to take it. And there's no doubt about that one, a goal by Pointer. Remember, that could be the goal that puts Coventry City in the first division next season. And there's the man holding up the banner, signifying the name of the scorer. Five minutes left for play, point of the scorer. Bad mistake for the Huddersfield goalkeeper. And here's Ray Pointer in action. Coventry supporters who are here now singing out with their sky blue song, as they call it. That's it, Smith. Chilliver out to McHale. Huddersfield have got to do something and do it quickly. And they won't do it that way. It's Massey, the outside left, who said in that shot. Goal kick to Coventry. Glazier, their goalkeeper, signed from Crystal Palace for £35,000. Coventry in a very, very happy position at the moment. Respect to goal. And Mitchell connected with that, it could well have been 2-0. Huddersfield looking distinctly unhappy at the moment. Number two is Kearns for Coventry. Almost half time now, might of course a little bit of injury time. In fact, there isn't. Our watches didn't agree with the referees. He's low for time now. Half time. The scorer was Pointer. Well, we made that a 44-minute half, but time is no matter. Coventry City have got the goal that could mean First Division football for the next season. But I don't think Huddersfield are going to take this lying down. They know the penalties for losing this match. I think they'll come out and make redoubled efforts in the second half. The wind, the dry ground are taking the toll of this match. So too is the tension under which it's being played. But still, another 45 minutes of this vital match to go, and Coventry City leading 1-0. Now remember, in the second half, Huddersfield Town, who will kick off, will be facing the wind. Left Smith, number 10, and away we go for the last 45 minutes of league football at Huddersfield this season. Goal, promising young player, way up to Rees. As the players came out, that's a goal kick. As the players came out for the second half, Jimmy Hill, the Coventry manager, raced on and had a word with his back fullback Kearns. What on earth is there's the trainer's bench. Huddersfield on the right, Coventry on the left. Don't know what Jimmy Hill, sitting in the stand, had to say, but might become apparent later in the game. Huddersfield fans who were behind this goal in the first half now move to the other end. Behind the goal that Huddersfield, their favourites are attacking. What was a foul? Foul by the outside left, Clements, Coventry. Free kick to Huddersfield. Now they must get two goals to win. Draw would please nobody but Southampton. Those who have stopped us all the fools. Cutting forward to McDowell. This is Leighton. He's got Gilliver in the middle. Well, things not going right for Huddersfield at the moment. Time Huddersfield Town on top of the second division, but the form in recent weeks, 12 points out of the last 13 games, have thrown promotion away, it seems. You never get that feeling when Huddersfield move on to the attack that they have the strength or the power or the skill to get a goal. Well, we might be mistaken. Corner kick. going to take the corner, McNeil. Outside right, number four and number five for Huddersfield have gone up. That's number four is Nicholson, number five, Coddington. Hale with the corner for Huddersfield. Getting into that tackle is Harris again. Gould. He's calling for a through one as he darts down the middle, but Gould couldn't get it to him. The game has been stopped and Coddington gets his name taken. Coddington getting his name taken. Must have shouted something. What a way to end the season. And who else? There's John Coddington, and the free kick has been given. He must have done something after the ball went. I didn't see it. Referee certainly did. Coddington's name taken. Now you can see the distance. Throw to Coventry. 10 minutes of the second half gone. 35 minutes left. Coventry lead 1-0. So in the promotion stakes, Huddersfield Town still on your marks, but Coventry City have heard the order get set. Now, Machen, cricket to Coventry. Machen is going to take it. He's running away, but the referee's after him. And the referee wants him. A lot of silly niggling stuff going on in this match. The man is beaten. He, 9 times out of 10, he gets fouled. Now, McHale going to take this free kick. He's claiming the Coventry players aren't 10 yards from the ball. Tension certainly getting on top of it. Challenging, that's a wee bit too strongly for Huddersfield. Gould. Mitchell, attempting that one for Reeves at the right wing. Trouble with Huddersfield is when they're clearing the ball, they're not finding their men. Nicholson, seen any. Always it's the Coventry man who's able to step in and get the ball. Gilliver moving away for Huddersfield. Massey's got a chance. Once again, Lazier very quick to come out of his goal, narrow the angle. Massey should have scored then. Instead, he's going to take the corner. Now, Sutton to McHale. And it comes to Smith. Can't claim they haven't had the chance. And free kick has been given. That spot of holding on Pointer. Free kick to Coventry. There's Ray Pointer, the man who got what could well prove a vital goal for Coventry City. Get to Coventry, going to be taken by Kenneth, right back. Oldfield read that one well, a good shot by Farmer. Throw to Huddersfield, number two is Atkins. Out of play. It's been out of play. I don't think the referee's seen the lines of flagging. Yes, he has now. His toe for a corner. It's Ray Pointer. Used to be the number one centre forward in England. Corner to Coventry. Again, the tall centre half back has come up, Curtis. So Coventry going all out for a second goal. And remember, the wind will blow this ball now towards the Huddersfield goal. ...25 minutes from the end. Coventry lead, 1-0. Nicholson. And Nicholson with another chance. There's nothing classical about this Coventry team, but it's certainly more effective than Huddersfield. Now McNabb for Huddersfield. Coventry hardly know when they're beaten. If they do make a mistake and Huddersfield get away, Coventry will come back and challenge. Quite often they're catching the Huddersfield players at the second attempt. Throw to Huddersfield. And the Coventry supporters singing out their anthem once again, but it's Smith for Huddersfield. Up down to McHale. That barely silenced the sky blue song. Corner, Huddersfield. McHale to take the corner. beautifully taken by the Fraser. Very fine goalkeeper. McHale, any take on Harrison, beat him. Leighton moved on to the right wing. Just on the left is number 8, Chilivo, headed that one wide. His hands on hips, just on the left. Striped shirt. There he is. Leading goal scorer for Huddersfield Town, 18 goals this season. McHale. Number 4. Nicholson to McHale. Nicholson again. Glazier being showered with toilet rolls at the far end, but the lines were flagging wildly for offside, and the whistle is gone. Well, Gould looking rather surprised. Didn't hear the whistle, but it's gone all right. And the referee now stopping the game so that the toilet rolls thrown by the Huddersfield fans at the far end can be removed. Game restarts with a free kick to Huddersfield Town, taken by Megan. Curtis, cricket to Huddersfield Town, and more toilet rolls shower into the goal mouth. Hale going to take the free kick for Huddersfield. ...20 minutes left for play. Coventry in the white lead 1-0. Glazier confident to deal with everything thrown at him so far. Somebody has suggested he's confident to deal with anything but toilet rolls. And there's the second goal. A bad mistake by the Huddersfield defence. A terrible mistake. And Gould has made it certain that, I would say, that Huddersfield now stay in the second division. Bob Gould, number 9, has got the goal that will keep Huddersfield down. Midway through the second half. Soft goal for Huddersfield to throw away. This is Gilliver to McHale. Gold for Coventry. corner kick. Yes. Now the referee is good to go. Paddington for Huddersfield. I think the Huddersfield players must now know in their heart of hearts that their chance of promotion has gone. They'll have all summer to work out how it was that in their last 14 games they picked up only 12 points. When in fact they picked up 39 points from 28 games. And a chance now for Huddersfield, and again it's scored. Well, you can't get promotion when you miss chances like that. And Link, a man who's got 11 goals this season, thrown away another chance. That really was the miss of a man who knows that the chance has slipped from his grasp. Come Coventry, this is good. Oh, a splendid tackle. Splendid tackle by McNabb. It's Coventry's throw, I think. Yes. This is the right halfback. Rook coming up to take it. Goal kick. Five minutes left for play. Coventry City lead 2-0. That'll do for Coventry. Time is on their side. They can do a little more to pick up 2 points in this match. Their goal average is so much inferior to Southampton, they can't even hope to get near it at all. Reese. That is Peter Dix of Trinket. Trinket to Huddersfield. McHale. McHale into Megan. Number three now is McDowell. Nicholson has moved up the forward line to try and some last desperate effort to get a goal. Now Smith. McHale. Silver moved on to the right. McHale deciding to try and go down the middle. A goal. Again all on his own. Pointer just coming up very slowly. And play on, and it's Machin. Machin back to Farmer. Obviously stopped, I think. They thought they were going to get a free kick. Machin. They decide to play the pattern game. Now Megan for Huddersfield. Mason. Doing well to hold on to that ball. Corner. Corner to Coventry City. Machen going to take it. 2 minutes to go, so Curtis doesn't even bother to come up for this one. Machen might well get that one again. Back to Ken. Low kick to. There's Clements, the outside left, who gave that goal kick to Huddersfield. So now away goes Atkins for Huddersfield. Huddersfield have conceded. They have now no hope either of picking up a point from this match or, which is more important, getting into the first division next season. And thousands of their supporters are leaving the ground knowing that they'll be watching second division football next season. At a minute of injury time, looking at his watch, he's got his whistle in his mouth, and the whistle goes for the end of the match. Coventry City have won 2-0. Their young supporters invade the pitch, but they now have to have a cliff-hanging, nail-biting finish for 10 days to see whether they're in the first division or not.
Those happy young Coventry City supporters are probably now not quite so happy, because with Southampton winning 3-2 at Plymouth, Southampton are now just 1 point behind Coventry City. And Coventry have completed their programme, whereas Southampton have 2 games to play. And because their goal average is so much better than Coventry's, Southampton virtually need just 1 point from those 2 matches to get into the first division. True, both those matches are away at Leighton Orient and at Manchester City, but I should imagine that 1 point will not be beyond the capabilities of Southampton. So the odds must be on Southampton getting up with Manchester City. And once again, the result of the match of the day, Coventry City won 2-0 at Huddersfield, but it looks as if it's not going to be enough to get them in the first division next season. And with that result, may I remind you that match of the day next week will be the FA Cup final between Everton and Sheffield Wednesday. So till next week, good night.